Hi, this is Michael on YouTube Guitar Tutorials on YouTube. And we are continuing the tutorial for U2's One. We're on the intro. The last few videos have covered the first, what I'll call two parts of the intro riff. I break it down into four parts. This part right here, down here, this is three, and then it goes to this pan position is four. So far we've covered these two parts. That was the first and the second part. I showed three different ways to play this first part. And then the double, two strings. So we showed three different ways here where he just changes up the lick a little bit. Down here, Edge doesn't change it up too much. He pretty much plays the same thing every time. Make sure you use that third finger and slide down the A string, okay? And then we're gonna go to this part, which is the third part. The third part is very similar to the first part in that Edge changes this up all the time, and he's always just playing around with the lick a little bit. So I'm gonna show three ways that I hear Edge playing this in different versions of the song, in different live versions of the song. And they're going to be similar, almost exactly like the three variations of the version we already went through in the first part. So in the third part, it's going to sound like this. Here are the three different versions, then we're going to zoom in and go through them. It's one, two. The first version was the double string pick version that we did down here. Second, third. That is very simple to do. It's very similar to this, what we did down here in the first part. So let's zoom in and let's go through the third part of the song here. Because I can't get the whole guitar in here, I'm gonna have to play some of this up here on the neck, and it's not gonna sound too great. But I do want to make this as clear as possible. So what we're gonna do here is you're going to slide up on the A string with the third finger from that second part. So if you recall, okay, when you slide up, when you get up here to the first position, then just take these three fingers and you're going to play them down like this. It's essentially, this is an F chord here, but you don't have to bar the E string. You're going to keep the E string open. So that's the D string on the third fret, G string on the second fret, and then the first fret B string. Okay. So, and then you're going to keep the E open. So you get this. And what we're going to do is we're going to pick the D string, and then you're going to use, again, these two fingers, and you're going to pick the B. We're going to do the first version of this is the B and the E string open together. Okay, so it's going to sound like this. D string, and then I'm picking the B and the E string. Now, you actually don't have to have this middle finger here on the G on the second fret, because we're not going to play that note. But it's just comfortable for me. You can just do this. Okay, I just like to have it, I just put it down there because it's what's comfortable for me. But we're only playing the D string, third fret, and then the B string, first fret, and the open E, okay? And we're gonna use this pinky here to do a little hammer on, hammer off. Okay, so we're gonna be doing that again. So essentially I'm hitting the D string, then the E and the B string, and then I'm putting this pinky down on the third finger B string, right there, and then I'm lifting. So D string, and then E and B open, and then put the pinky down on the B, third fret, and then play the B and the E, and then lift and play the B and the E again, and then hammer. Hammer on the B, and then when you lift up, play the E and the B again. And then up and play again. Now let me see if I can show that with my picking here. There you go. Okay. So hit the D with the thumb. Pick with here, the B and the E. Put the pinky down on the third finger, third fret, and hit that. Hit, lift and play it again, and then hammer, and then lift and play it again. Let's try it down here. See if we can look right down the neck. All right, there we go. So now you can see me. There we go. Then hammer, and then pick on the way up. Notice there was one pick there where I'm hammering on that pinky, and I'm not picking down here, right? So it's D string, E and B, then put the pinky down on the third fret, B string, and then lift and play the E and the B again, and now hammer. See, I didn't play down here, and then lift and play the E and the B string again. You're always playing the E and B string together with these two fingers down here, so we have. It is. So that's the first way. So let's play the whole lick here for a second, see how it all comes together. Slide, go right into here. Now watch my hand. There's that little lick at the end. And then you put the B and you do a hammer and pull. B. You only pluck it once, and then hammer, and then pull with the pinky. Okay, there it is, right there. So the entire lick up here is. Now, what's also important is if you be careful on your touch, and this is where Edge is just brilliant, because he's played it so many times, but he has a very nice touch with his right and his left hand together. He's not, be careful of hitting your nails. If you hit your nails, this is going to come out like, you don't want to hit it too hard or get the nails under there and clobber those strings. I try to use the softer part of my tip of my fingers. Make it soft. So that's the first part up here. It's just those two fingers. Hammer down, lift, pick, and then do the hammer on, hammer off, and the hammer and the pull. And then you're going to hit the D, and you're going to slide down two frets to the fifth on the D from the third to the fifth fret. So the entire lick is. So you're going to do. Think about that transition. You're going to do that really quickly, right after you do the hammer and the pull off. Okay? Like that. Let me play that again, show the hammer up here. I didn't do that before. There it is. Just one pick, hammer, and then pull. And you might want to practice this. And you gotta be careful not to hit the E string when you do that hammer. So be careful not to hit the E and go like that. Don't pull down, pull up. Like that. That's what we just did a second ago. Now, the other two ways Edge, I've heard him do this, is he just plays around with the order of the B and the E string like we did on the down here when we did this. Okay, so this time what we're going to do, I'm going to do a slightly different order. Whereas the first time I played the E and the B string every time, this time I'm going to play a little different order and play some single notes. So it's going to start the same D, D string, then the open E and the B together. Okay, now what we're going to do is play the, put the pinky down and play the third fret B string, lift and then play the E string, and then hammer on the B quickly, and then lift on the after that hammer, lift and then play the B string. So you're going to hear this, okay? The melody is this. So you're going to do that by both B and E string first, and then hit the B string third fret, the pinky down, lift and hit the E string, and now hammer the B, and then lift the B and play the B string. And what that will sound like is this. I'm not picking when I come back down. I'm using the hammer in there to get one of the notes. So it's... You're hearing da, 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 but with a hammer. And then the same hammer on, hammer off. Hammer on and pull off. And then slide. So we've just done two different ways. We've got this version, which is picking the B and the E all the time. That's the first way. Now we have this way. One more time. And notice that E keeps ringing through, okay? When I hit both strings first, now hit the B on the third fret, and when I lift, I hit the E, let it ring, and then hammer. So that E is still ringing. And then lift and hit the B. And then do the hammer on pull off. And that is the second way. So now we've got... And then we have da 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 da. And now we're going to do the third version, which sounds like this. The melody is. So instead of, we're going to do. And I've heard Edge do that third version also. Same type, exact same variation that he did down here. So the first way was all double strings with a hammer. The second way, and now the third way. So what that was D, play the B and the E string again. Now hit the B string, this finger, first fret. Lower this, play the B string third fret, lift, play the first fret on the B string, and then hammer, and then play the E string. So it's two strings B and E, put the pinky down, lift, play the B string, hammer, and then play the E. So you get and then the hammer on, pull off, and then slide. So let's now zoom down the neck. Okay, so let's play all three versions here. Here's the two-string version, the first version. Now we're gonna play the second version I played, which was... is that melody, so we do that. And remember that hammer in there. It's very slick. That's a really good version I just did there. Because you get that. And that was the second version. Now let's do the third version, which is this melody. And we've just covered three parts now of the third part of the intro riff. And then, when you put them all together, you can change those up. And you can do, what I like to do is play the first double version here and here, and then the second time you come around, use one of the other versions here and the other versions here, and then the same thing on the third time around. Let's try this out. So that was the first three versions I just repeated up there after doing the first part and the second part and the third part. So now let's go on to the fourth part. And the fourth part, we already just started, we mentioned after the hammer-on pull-off, you slide, you pick this D string, you slide from the third to the fifth fret. Okay. So here we go. We already went through this slide. You're going to hit this D string and slide into the fifth. Now keep, this time you're gonna need this middle finger on the G, because we're gonna actually play that note, okay? So this time you want that formation where the third finger on the fifth, the middle finger on the fourth on the G, and then the first finger here on the B on the third fret, okay? We are not gonna play the E string this time. So it's just these three. Three notes. When you slide in, you let that D string, which on the fifth fret, ring out. Let that ring while you're playing the rest of this, okay? It's very important. So you slide in, hit the G string on the fourth fret, okay? So then hit the G and the B string together and hammer the pinky down on the G. So you get. So the whole thing so far, G, G, B, and then pull, da-na-na. Two strings together, G and B, and then hammer again. So it's a da-na-na-na. Practice this, hit the G once. I'm only hitting the G string once. It's going to be the G and the B, actually, when you do that. But this pinky is doing all the work. Practice that. So you slide in on the D. Sorry, I'm playing up here, so it's a little harder. G string. G and B string together. Hammer. Pull. Hammer. So slowly. And actually, it looks like I play the G and the B string again. Okay, so I slide in, play the G string alone on the fourth fret, then pick the G and the B string, and then do the hammer, and then lift and play the G and the B string again, and then just the D string. There we go. So it sounds like this, slowly. Let's look right down the neck here. That's just the G string, then the G and the B, hammer, lift and play the G and the B string, and then play the D string. And then slide into the beginning. nice bass tone. Here it is now, a little faster. And that is that fourth part, okay? I think I did that thoroughly enough. Okay, now I'm gonna go through the entire intro that we've just learned, the first, second, third, and fourth parts. I'm gonna use what I call the two-finger method. So I'm playing the G and the B string, plucking at the same time, and then I'm plucking the E and the B string up here at the same time. I'm not doing the other two variations. Nice and slow, it'll sound something like this. Notice, I essentially did all the little subtleties that I explained right there, nice and slow. Let me go through that again and explain them as I'm playing it. B and E string. Hammer. B and E string. Hammer on, pull off. Slide. Hammer. Pick. Slide. B and E string together. Hammer. Hammer on, pull off. Slide. Single string G. G and B together. Hammer. G and B together. D. And that's it. You put it all together and you get. Okay, I threw in the last two riffs in there. I did the other versions that we discussed. Mila is here and listening to one, and I'm boring her to death, as I usually do. She is so patient. Mila is, by the way, a 9-year-old golden retriever. She's a therapy dog at New York Presbyterian Medical Center in New York City. She's a total sweetheart, and she has actually saved a life, believe it or not. So there's a little side note that has nothing to do with guitar. It's a long story. If you're interested, you can email me and I'm happy to tell you the story, but she's a pretty incredible dog. So that takes us toward the end. That's it. We have just covered U2's one intro, the famous intro. We've done it all with three variations in the first and third parts. And we can stop here and move to the next part, which is gonna go to kind of this bridge at the end of the intro. It goes up here back into first position and then goes in after that into the rotary, which is my favorite part. So I'm looking forward to teaching you that. But let's stop here and we'll move on and go to the next part, kind of the end part of the intro. Stop, stop, stop. And bring back Springsteen.